A giant poster quoting a Google dictionary definition of the word woman has been removed from a wall in Liverpool. The poster read, woman, women, noun, adult, human, female. But according to one LGBTQ activist, it qualified as hate speech and was deemed dangerous for transgender women. I'm joined now from Newcastle by Dr. Adrian Harrop, who campaigned for the poster's removal. And in our central London studio, we can speak to Kelly J. Keane-Minshall, founder of the women's rights organisation Standing for Women, who were behind the poster. Hello to you both. Dr. Adrian Harrop, to you first. What is so offensive about the dictionary definition of women?
There is nothing inherently offensive with the dictionary definition of women. That really isn't what this was about at all. This is about what that particular poster, presented in that particular way, in that particular location, represents, and what the underlying meaning and the thinking that was driving putting up that poster.
So what was the underlying meaning then to anyone looking at it? Was it any more than a dictionary definition?
So that poster was put up by a campaign group that is led by Miss Keane-Minshall, who has led and spearheaded a campaign against trans people, particularly against trans women, that's extended over several months now, mostly online, but also in a real-life environment, where she sought to demonise trans women and to highlight them as dangerous sexual predators. This poster that was put up is a symbol of that campaign. It is that campaign made flesh, as it were. And for transgender people who are living and working in Liverpool, it is a reminder to them that they are under such immense public scrutiny for every single aspect of their identity, their behaviour, their body shape, their appearance. And that campaign is led by this woman, Miss Keane-Minshall, a.k.a. Posie Parker. And that's the reason why it should have been taken down.
Let's get a response then from Kelly J. Keane-Minshall. This was part of a targeted transphobic campaign by you and your organisation.
Well, firstly, I'd like to remind Mr. Harrop that I'm married, so I'm Mrs. Keane-Minshall. And secondly, the point of this campaign was simply to highlight the absurdity that in 2018, saying woman equals adult human female is an offensive thing to say. And Mr. Harrop delightfully has proven that point by having a tantrum and contacting every CEO or every executive on the board of PrimeSight until it got removed.
This wasn't a one-off, though. This wasn't just a poster that you put up with the definition of woman on it. And we should say you're wearing that definition on the T-shirt that you're wearing today at Kelly J as well. What Mr. Harrop is saying, that this was part of a long-running campaign by you and your organisation, and as such, it was offensive.
How is the definition of woman offensive?
Adrian Harrop.
What a ludicrous thing to say.
Adrian Harrop, your response.
It really isn't about the definition itself, though, is it, Posie? It's not about that. It's about the fact that you have specifically...
Mrs. Keane-Minshall, Adrian Harrop.
Mrs. Keane-Minshall, I apologise, and it's Dr. Harrop, thank you. You have explicitly excluded trans women from your definition of
Absolutely.
Women.
Absolutely. Of course I exclude trans women for the definition of woman, adult, human, female.
That is not something that is appropriate.
Would you like
in
to explain to us as a
society.
Doctor what a woman is, Mr. Harrop?
A woman? Dr. Harrop, thank you, Mrs. Keane-Minshall. A woman is a person who identifies as a woman.
Is that what you do when somebody comes into A&E? You ask their identity before you treat them?
Absolutely not, Mrs. Keane-Minshall, and you are fully aware of that.
It's not about identity, is it?
I do not
what you're
identify
seeking to do, what you and your misogynistic allies seek to do is erase what it means to be a woman in law and in life. And that is why this campaign has been absolutely essential. If you didn't push women to the point that we are very, very angry, that we feel we have to protect the language around us by using words like cervix, havers, menstruators, cervical cancer, obliterating the word woman, not even using it in campaign material, we wouldn't feel the the need to assert the fact that the meaning of woman is only the definition, is only adult human female. So I think the ball is in very much in your court.
What do you have, Kelly J.K. Minshall, against trans women?
I don't. I just don't think they're women.
So I will counter that point, Mrs. Keane-Minshall, by stating that you have led a directly transphobic campaign that has extended over several months.
You attack, intimidate and harass women on Twitter all the time.
Over a period of months, Mrs. Keane-Minshall, and you cannot deny that. You have had a hand
Mr.
in this.
How many women have you threatened to report to their employers? Are you under guidance at the moment because you call women disgusting misogynist names on Twitter?
That's not true at all, Mrs. Keane-Minshall, and
you should be.
Well,
you threatened, you told a woman on Twitter she didn't delete...
Speaking of Twitter, Kelly J. Keane-Minshall, about your own Twitter account, which has currently been suspended, both your Posie Parker account and your human female account. You yourself were questioned by police, West Yorkshire police, after that you made towards Susie Green, the mother of a 16-year-old, took her child to Thailand.
Would you like to elaborate on that accusation? It was because I said I thought it was wrong to castrate a 16-year-old child.
I'm asking whether by using the language that you're using, castration, you were being deliberately provocative.
No, I'm being deliberately truthful in an age where it doesn't seem feasible that people can just speak the truth.
Well,
the truth is, most women aren't comfortable with calling trans women women and giving up our rights to men.
Let's talk about truth and freedom of speech. Adrian Harrop, can I talk about truth and freedom of speech? Why did you want to see this poster censored? If you didn't agree with it, could you not have put up your own alongside it?
I absolutely respect the fact that Mrs. Keane-Minshall does have a right to free speech. What Mrs. Keane-Minshall does not have a right to do is to make transgender people in Liverpool feel unsafe and unwelcome in their own community.
With the definition of woman?
Yes, with
your... If you can't see the absurdity in what you're saying, then I don't know if anybody can help you. It cannot be such that the definition of woman, the dictionary definition of woman, is offensive. Do you know how offensive that is to women?
Mrs. Keane-Minshall, no one is objecting to the dictionary definition. No one is wanting
to alter the dictionary definition.
However, the fact that this term has been appropriated by your overtly transphobic campaign makes transgender people feel unsafe and unwelcome in their own
community. A dictionary definition on a billboard makes men feel unsafe.
It is the symbolism behind the poster.
The symbolism is black and white, plain English truth. That is the symbolism. The symbolism is that we knew when we put the billboard up that chaps like yourself would think that they could control what we think and what we say. We know this. And that's why we did it. It's absolutely time that women are allowed to talk about ourselves, our spaces, our rights, and our legal rights without men like you telling us that we are not allowed to speak.
Okay, I'm going to have to wrap it up there. Kelly J. Keane-Minshall, Dr. Adrian Harrop, thank you both very much indeed. Mark Austin coming up next.